It's 3-2. And we are back here with Corpse Party. So we're going to go chapter 4. And we're going to continue this shit. Let's see. Yeah, we're in with Shinojaki Aoyomi. I can't tell if that was the game or out in my living room. Give me one sec. Must have been the game. Okay, that was really realistic. Okay, anyway. I can't go this way. I can't bring myself to see Suzumoto like that again. I feel like I'll lose my mind. So what exactly do we do then? It's the doll, isn't it? Where is that coming from? Sounds muffled, like one of the Toy Mika doll telephones, but it's definitely close. That damn doll is making noise again. Weep, weep. Okay, let's go. Let's not go that way. The air is really heavy. It makes my ears ring. Let's head back to 1A before going any further, just to check in, okay? I'd really like to see Yui-san, Miss Yui. We'll see. I don't know if that's going to happen. Well, let's go just in case. Okay. And we'll go up around the boulder. That's not a boulder, then. That would be a hole in the ground, not a boulder. It's empty. That was full of some congealed shit earlier. Okay. The mess you wrote. But nothing new has been added. Okay. Let me say it won't budge. Okay, well, I'm back in 1A. I don't think anything's happening. There's a couple of them on the floor. There's one thing I've learned from all this. The children are victims, too. They're not at fault here. They're not the ones we should hate. The murderer is the one who created the cycle of resentment and cruelty. The murderer is our true enemy. Yes. That, yeah. Okay. Oh, Sayonoki! Hey! My friend! No. You're a liar! Liar, liar! The child spirits don't give a crap about the killer's stupid repentance. Give me back Suzumoto! I've said it before and I'll say it again. Your voice really travels. Kushinuma! It's my friend! You okay, Shinozaki? You're one to ask. What on earth happened to you? There's blood everywhere.
Yeah.
Well, as soon as you turned that corner before I got struck in the noggin from behind. But I'm fine. Don't worry. Don't know exactly where I was locked up. In some gloomy little room. The child spirits were there along with some really big dude holding a hammer. How do you get here then? Well, after a little while in that room, I lost consciousness again. When I woke up, I was in the first floor hallway. Did someone carry you there? Either way, I'm just glad you're all right. I don't know how much more this I can take. I don't want anyone else to die. Yeah. I am not mistaken. What do you mean? If each of those spirits were to find peace, even if They have to be appeased one by one. Then these closed spaces, given shape by their bound souls, should not be able to remain in existence. We let them hear the killer's regrets, though, and it did nothing to help us. What kind of person are we dealing with here anyway? The man with the hammer who attacked you, he was their murderer. You serious? Seems he got a violent streak even in death as well. He harms the living indiscriminately. So your first order of business should be to quell his wanton behavior. And how are we supposed to do that? Based on my mentor's research, that antique doll you've got in your hand should be a good place to start. It belonged to him in life. He was given it by his mother, and reportedly he relies on it to keep his mind level and his heart in balance. I'm certain he must be looking for it. Hold on a sec. Who's this mentor of yours? My personal affairs are not your concern. What's happening? Sorry about that. You'll need to find that man's body or his remains at any rate. He should be in the school building somewhere, and if you find him and return the doll to their side, everything will be just fine. Miss Sayanekiko? Your friend's death is your own fault. What the hell was that about? Can we really believe a word she just said? Maybe not, but it's as good a place to start as any. Earlier, as I was passing through the first floor, the doll started crying and weeping loudly. Dearest, let me tell you, I sure don't miss having that thing around. Well, we might be able to use it like a tracking device. It could lead us right to the murderer's body. Either way, let's just keep moving, okay? Or can you? How's your head? Wow, that's quite a bump you got. That was lousy aim, but he still hit my head full force with the handle. If he'd been more accurate, I'd be a gunner for sure. Damn, child killer. You're lucky I just so happened to have some cloth bandage with me. I'll see what I can do about dressing that wound. Part of your prop closet, I take it. Guess I should be thankful for your horror obsession after all. Okay, up this way. Okay, we'll save. Okay. I like having another person around. I'm going to be honest. Okay. Still can't go up this way. That's where Miss Yui is. If I... No. She's on the second floor, isn't she? No, this is the second floor. Never mind. I'm dumb. An unseen force is pushing you back. Okay, cool. Still no access up there. I guess let's go back down to the first floor. I mean, that's as good of a guess as any currently. Because that's where it started crying. Okay. Six steps, horse, 13th paces, roster. So from the red door, I guess let's start up here, huh? Oh, I already got her tag, okay. Go around you, sorry about you dying and all that. I guess. Three, four, five, six, one. One, two, three, four. Oh, I nailed it! Okay, one of the floorboards here is slightly raised. Peering through the crack, you just barely make out some sort of bag. Can I pull it out? Yes. Sniffle. With a bit of fidgeting, you were able to remove the item from the compartment. It's a small bag made of hemp and stained liberally with blood. There's a name tag attached to the front. Emily Oast Elementary School, class 35, Ryo Yoshizawa. What's going to be inside? I wonder. Here, have a look. No way, I'm not touching that thing. You look. Fine. I have a bad feeling about this. It can be an eyeball. Well, what is it? What's in the bag? Be for yourself. Bag appears to contain a severed human tongue. Return it? It's name tag. It's a boy's name. It must be the ghost of the little boy. Shizaki. Okay. What do we do with it? It's so nasty. We give it back to its rightful owner. Huh? You are your mind? Ryu's tongue. Okay. I think I know where this needs to go. I know where this needs to go. We're going to take it to the boy in the infirmary. If we die, hopefully we don't. That's all I can say. Granted, I mean, I've never seen a severed human tongue. I mean, I've seen a lot of shit. Currently, I'm going through like coroner files for at my job. So I've seen a lot of shit, but I've never seen a severed human tongue. Crap, he's looking right at me. Ryu. That's right, I know your name. Show him the tongue? Yes. I feel bad for happening, but I can't sympathize with what you're doing. Hurting strangers because of your own despair, putting them into a horrible place like this, and killing them. You killed our dear friend. I can never forgive you for that. But this is yours. It's part of your body, so I'm going to give it back to you. Hand Ryo's tongue. My tongue. Thank you, miss. Oh. Whoa, what's going on? Please don't tell me we die because we gave him his tongue back. Damn it, another earthquake. You gotta be kidding me. I won't get anywhere by walling in self-pity here. Yuka, I swear I'll protect you. Please wait for me. First things first, though, I need to check on Naomi. The girl in the red dress. Hey, you wait! We're gonna check on Naomi first, and then we're gonna follow her. What the? I don't let this door unlocked. Feels like someone's on the other side pushing against it to keep me from getting in.
Naomi,
are you in there? That's you. Open the door, please. There's no answer. Is it someone else? Okay. I think it's telling us we have to follow. Still can't get to Miss Yui. God, I really hope we, like, there's some, like, space-time mumbo-jumbo to where everyone lives at the end of this. Because I'm going to be real sad if everyone ends up dying because, we're bad or something. I don't know. Okay, let's see. Mother. Okay. All right. Okay. okay, mother, I'm sorry. I've already seen you. Most likely the killer's body is in there. And that's where we have to return the doll to. But I'm not 100% for certain. Okay, let's come in here first. Still can't get it. Okay, we need to... Well, we can't really find Naomi right now, but... Someone's cell phone, yes. Quart Seiko's cell phone. This is Shinohara's, isn't it? 16 to be in the middle of texting someone, she dropped her phone. The text entry still window still open. While confirming the phone number, such she wound up inadvertently reading the whole thing. Shinohara. I'm sorry, Shinohara. I really didn't mean to. I didn't think Naomi should see this. Not now, at any rate. I'll curse, kill you. I'll curse you. I hate you so much. Just okay, I've seen you already. Okay. Now where to? I mean, down here we can't get across this at all. And the girl in the red dress is gone. So do we have to go up to the third floor again? Naomi. Satoshi, please don't leave me alone in here like that. Sorry, I was out looking for Yuka. Okay, that makes sense. Did you find her? No, the corridor that leads back to where I saw her last went back to being a wall. I can't find any way of getting to the other building anymore. Other building? There's a whole other building? Yeah. Looks like the school Yuka, Murashige, and I were in is different from this one. We need to find some other way of traveling from one space to another. That would be ideal, yeah. Wait a minute. Were you standing out here instead of waiting inside the infirmary? I was attacked in there earlier by some kind of black shadowy mist. So I was a little scared to be in there, afraid it might attack me again. You serious? I'm really sorry about that then. Don't worry about it, but there's something in there for sure. I think we should keep our distance. No objections here. What's in here? I'm gonna save. Okay. Now where do we go? I really... It appears as if some... Well, at least it's not feel like... look doesn't look like it's just a decoration on the wall anymore. Okay. We have to go back upstairs, maybe? I didn't mean to go back down the stairs. Has anything changed? There's no, oh, I thought that because I think I did that last time too, where there was a rattly and I thought that was like something. There's no longer anyone in the stall. There definitely should be someone in that stall. I really have no idea where we're going in now. Oh, that was the wrong one. It's Tobias Shako. Her neck's been squeezed into an hourglass shape with a deep crimson rope right in the center. Oh, right. We took her body down. I forgot about that. I was like, Shako should be in the stall, but no. Wait, the smell. Okay. Yeah, I can't imagine that smells great. There's nothing in here. No one know what Naomi was so scared about him there. It's nothing there. I really just have no idea what we're doing next. Because, like, this is all closed off. I can't get over there. Right? And this over here is just the entrance to the basement. There's nothing over here. This door is locked. What if we go to where the tongue was? No, I know. I'm dumb. Not this again. Okay. Sure, no problem. Okay, cool. Stay there. What are we gonna get? I'm guessing it's a key to the red room.
Naomi!
Naomi, now grab it.
Okay.
Okay, got it. I was right. A blood red key level custodian's closet. Nicely done in there. In fact, you seem totally unfazed. Did you figure out what we needed to do on your own or something? Actually, had to do something similar before with Seiko. Did you? Same year, but with Yuka. Let's keep moving. We'll find her. I know we will. All right, and we can watch the custodian. That's television, isn't it? I did find that video cassette in the air building. I hold some important information. Use the custodian's key? Yes. I hope I don't regret this. We turned out the lights. What the? What's going on? Why is it so cold? Something really smells and it's pushed back in here. Can you find a light switch anywhere? I'll try. Found it. Whew, thanks. Man, does it stink in here? And it's not just mold, is it? Probably not. That's odd. Oh, nothing. It's like deja vu. I could swear I've seen this room before. Well, fresh base here. Something sticky seemed to have melted all over the surface. There are stains everywhere. It's an old Japanese style Fusuma sliding door, presumably opening to a closet. It's torn and stained in equal measure throughout its surface. Since he's off by this closet, I get the feeling it's the one door we shouldn't open. Yeah. There's a video camcorder lying on top of the TV. Its video cassette deck is empty. Very also seems to have run out. However, as the LCD display isn't turning on. What is something this recent doing in a place this old? Maybe belong to someone who was brought here, like us. Yeah, that does make sense. Fortunately, there's no cord here to hook it up to the TV, and it's out of battery, so it doesn't look like we'll be getting much use out of it. There's a magazine article from a publication called Strange But True, Stories of the Occult. There's a Their old moldy tea leaves floating in the stagnant water. An old beat up tea kettle. Inside the cabinet, there's a notebook labeled Night Guard Logbook and a few crumpled pieces of paper. Heavy host, elementary school, confinement, Tau something, now taking applications. The sheet of paper contained what appears to be seemingly endless list of names. Glaring as worn, however, makes it impossible to confirm exactly what's written. Yeah, I know. Okay. Alright, I'm going to end off the episode here. We're not going to exit. I'm probably going to get up, walk around for a sec, then come back and record the next episode. Hopefully, we can beat chapter 4. That'd be really cool. Anyway, thank you guys all so much for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.